Let us now study an important section in alternating currents, that is power in AC circuits. See, we are given with an alternating current circuit with a section having circuit impedance Z phasor and an EMF E naught angle 0 degrees connected across it, which is corresponding to time function E naught sin omega t. Now, depending on the value of phasor, a current phasor flows through the section, and let us consider the value of current phasor is given as EMF phasor by Z phasor. Here EMF is E naught angle 0 degree, and Z phasor let us consider it is given as Z angle phi. So in this situation we can write the value of current amplitude is E naught by Z, and its phase angle is minus phi at initial instant. So we can write time function of current can be written as this I naught sine of omega t minus phi. Here the value of phi may be positive or negative depending on the value of Z. If it is more inductive, then it will be having a negative phase for current. Current will lag behind. And if impedance will be having more capacitive reactance, in that situation, it will have a tendency to keep current ahead of EMF and phase. That depends on the value of phi in case to case. Now, from this equation 1 and 2, we can write, if we calculate the instantaneous power supplied by AC source, and this instantaneous power we can simply write as EI, because E is the at any time potential difference across the source and I is the instantaneous current supplied by it. So it will be EI. If we substitute the values, E can be taken as E naught sine omega t multiplied by current. We can write as I naught. I just open this trigonometric factor. This will be sine omega t cos phi minus cos omega t sin phi. So the value of instantaneous power we are getting is E naught I naught, and here the first factor is sin square omega t cos phi minus the second factor is E naught I naught sin omega t cos omega t sin phi. Now this is the instantaneous power in the circuit. And here if we calculate the average value of this power per cycle, if we calculate, then the average value we can see in the first term, E naught I naught cos phi is a constant. Sin square omega t is a time varying factor which has an average value 0.5. So we can write its average value E naught I naught 1 by 2 cos phi. And for the second term you can see this E naught I naught. Sin omega t cos omega t can be written as half sin 2 omega t, and a sinusoidal function has an average value 0. So you can directly see in average value the second term does not have any contribution. So its value will be 0. And instantaneous power at any instant, average power per cycle we can consider to be available at every instant. This can be written as half E naught I naught cos phi. And just to write it in a simplified manner, here we can write it E naught by root 2 multiplied by I naught by root 2 cos phi. And this can be written as ERMS IRMS cos phi. This is the function we are going to use for calculation of average power delivered by an AC source to a circuit, which is the product of ERMS, IRMS and cos phi. Here the factor cos phi is termed as a power factor. This is given a separate name because in various circuit, the power, average power consumed by the circuit depends mainly on the phase difference between the EMF and current. That's why it is a very important factor which is given a separate name, power factor. We are going to use it in many cases in upcoming sections.